March is Women's History Month, so I decided to kickstart my video series by devoting an entire video to the lead actresses of the future. While we've witnessed actresses like Viola Davis do the damn thing with a nose full of snot thicker than Meg The Stallion, it's time to usher in a new class of actresses. Ladies who will follow in the footsteps of Halle Berry to deliver Oscar-winning performances for years to come. So on this list, I decided to go with actresses who I think is going to have a breakout year in 2020. So all of them are in some big movies that should get a lot of recognition, so pay attention. There's no order to this list, and I'm going to throw in two honorable mentions at the end of the list. Kiki Layne is a talented young actress who captured all of our emotions in If Beale Street Could Talk. And then in 2019, she showed us her range in Native Son and Captive State. Now 2020 looks to be her breakout year with two movies that are sure to be blockbusters. Coming to America, the sequel to Eddie Murphy's classic, she plays Prince Akeem's daughter Mika, and mark my words, you're gonna have to pay attention. Then, she's in visionary director Gina Prince-Bythewood's, the one who brought you Love and Basketball, her new film, The Old Guard, alongside Oscar winner Charlize Theron. Kiki is able to deliver all types of emotion on screen. And we're gonna see her not only bring the funny with Eddie Murphy, but also dish out some high power action sequences. So be on the lookout for that. Next up, we have Davine Joy Randolph, who made a name for herself on Broadway, winning a Tony Award for her role in Ghost. Last year, she burst onto the scene as Lady Reed in Dolomite Is My Name. This year, I think she's gonna take over the world. Randolph has four roles you should be checking for. That's High Fidelity, that's out now on Hulu. She's also in The United States versus Billie Holiday, alongside Andra Day and Trevante Rhodes. Throw in two other movies, Late Shift and Kajillionaire, which was picked up by Focus after the Sundance Film Festival, and mark my words, you're gonna memorize her name. Taylor Page is about to be out of here. She was a standout actress and love interest in White Boy Rick, but in 2020, she's the lead actress in the story that took Twitter by storm, the biopic of Zola. That's right, I heard this is a ratchet bunch of excitement coming out of Sundance. This film was the highlight at that film festival, and she's gonna follow this movie up with Miss Rainey's Black Bottom. Being able to play off Chadwick Boseman and Viola Davis, who I mentioned before, we could be seeing Taylor in a lot of movies to come. Since we're on Taylor, I'm gonna give you another Taylor, Taylor Russell. This young lady stole the show in one of my favorite movies of 2019, Waves. She delivered a performance that I honestly will never forget. When it comes to emotions, she can display them so well that it will suck you into any scene she's in. She's a phenom when it comes to acting, and in 2020, she'll star in The Escape Room 2, plus she has two other movies in post-production. Dr. Bird's Advice for Sad Poets, as well as Words on the Bathroom Walls. Taylor's one of those actresses who's doing a lot of YA works. Those are immensely popular books, and the movies that they're turning out are turning out to be really, really, really good. So keep her name on your radar. She's gonna be a force in the future, I guarantee it. Next up, Dominic Fishback. I can't stop singing this young lady's praises. I saw her perform a dramatic performance at her school that I was honored enough to host. There were a bunch of rappers and singers there, and she stole the show by doing a performance piece at a talent show. Now she's set to do her thing in the untitled Fred Hampton Project with Daniel Kaluuya and Lakeith Stanfield. This young lady is the future of Hollywood. Her talent is unmatched, and the scary part about it all is she's just getting started. Next, I have Bresha Webb. She has been doing her thing for years in projects like Ride Along and on the TV show Marley. But after Tyler Perry's Fall from Grace and the upcoming Meet the Blacks 2, The House Next Door, she should be a mainstay in all of your favorite films. Now her specialty is comedy, but she also does dramatic work. I hope to see her in a lot more dramatic roles to come. Recently, she strung together a season of consistent work, and with each project, she's been the most memorable performance in each of them. Bresha is the future, and she should be the present as well, but 2020 is gonna change things for her. I see her having a big year in years to come. Tiffany Boone is ready to have a huge 2020. Coming off her hit series, The Chi, she's currently starring in Jordan Peele's new project on Amazon Prime called Hunters, which also stars the legendary Al Pacino. You can catch her on this show, but she's also working with George Clooney on his new film, The Midnight Sun. She has a small role in The Little Fires on Hulu. That's with Reese Witherspoon and Kerry Washington as well. Tiffany Boone is a star in the making. Next up, I want to give a shout out to my homegirl, Lashana Lynch. I had the pleasure of meeting her on set of Captain Marvel. And let me tell you something. She's also about to wield her license to kill in the new 007, No Time to Die. That should set her up for a big future. And with that fame, I see Marvel actually making her role a lot bigger in Captain Marvel, which will put her in the front of all of these blockbuster films, at least for the next 5 years. So Lashana Lynch doesn't even have 100,000 followers on Instagram right now, but she is gonna have a big and bright future. So put her name in your little Rolodex. Lashana Lynch is a thing, and she's gonna be a superstar. Now for my honorable mentions. I think these two ladies are very talented, but they're pretty famous and pretty big. First, we're gonna go with Letitia Wright, who is the Black Panther sister. So that Marvel thing has her booked up. She's not able to do as many roles as the other actresses can because she's booked up with this Marvel thing. But trust, coming out of it, she's gonna be a mega star. So put her on your list as well. And I'm also gonna throw in, as an honorable mention, Cynthia Erivo. She's already been nominated for an Oscar in Harriet. She's an amazing actress who's playing Aretha Franklin. She's also has a bunch of other great roles as well. She did her thing on Broadway, and now she's breaking into Hollywood. She's gonna get the EGOT very soon. She's a superstar already, but she's still sort of making her path forward. So I'm gonna throw her in here as an honorable mention, but she's the top slot, because she's already been nominated for an Oscar, right? So there you have it, my list of actresses to watch in 2020. These actresses that I named today are gonna be and should be the lead Black actresses in every role that calls for one. So be on the lookout for them and check back for more lists. Your boy Zilla Valentine. Peace.
Godzilla!
Yeah. Zilla bitch.
Godzilla!
No, that's my thing.